on. We have to discuss the further matrices operations. Operations means the mathematical operations. The mathematical operations are basically four binary operations, which you know that plus, minus, multiply, and divide. So if we discuss the first one is equality matrix. What is equality matrix? Equality matrix or equal matrix? Equal matrix means both the matrices A and B are equal if and only if all the elements and the places of the elements is same. If the first entry is 1 in the A, then it should be the first entry in is 1 in the B. And you can see that the first row is 1, 0, 0. Second row is 2, 1, 0 in A matrix, and 5, 2, 3, third row in A matrix. As you can see that in B matrix, we have also the first entry is 1, 0, 0, 2, 1, 0, 5, 2, 3 is the same as the A matrix. All the entries of both the matrices same. That's why A is equals to B. This is the single condition which we can write both the matrices equal. What is the condition? All the entries, all the elements should be same, order should be same, number should be same. There is not a single difference between both the matrices. Then we can say that both the matrices same. Next, move on addition and the subtraction of matrices, which is very easy. And the only one condition we can just know that the condition is the sum of two matrices or the sum or difference of two matrices A and B of the same size or same order. Then we can add or subtract both the matrices. If the order of both A and B is same, then we can add or subtract both the matrices. As you can see that if C is the resultant matrix, so we can add A and B or A minus B. And note that matrices of different size cannot be added or subtracted. This is the main condition of addition and subtraction. If both the matrices have a different order, then we cannot add or subtract the matrices. If we say that A matrix have 7 elements and B matrix have 9 elements, so we cannot add or subtract the matrices. Next, move on some examples. So if we have a matrix A, which we have order is 2 and by 3, and B matrix is a 2 by 3 order same. You can see that A matrix order and the B matrix order is same. That's why we can add. So the proper method to add the matrix is we can just add first element to first element. 7 plus 1 resultant is 8. Now 3 plus 5 result is 8. Now minus 1 plus 6, which becomes 5. 2 minus 4, which becomes minus 2, minus 2, minus 2. Minus 5 and minus 2 becomes minus 7, and the last element is 6 plus 3, which becomes 9. So each entry add with the corresponding entry of the second matrix. Each entry of the first matrix add with the corresponding entry of the second matrix. So first entry add with the first, second with the second, third with the third, and then one first with the first, second rows, second with the second, and third with the third. So you got the same order resultant matrix, which is also a 2 by 3 order. Next, move on. Some properties. If we add any matrix with the 0 and 0 to any matrix, there will be no change. This is called additive identity. 0 is the additive identity. If you add 0 with any number, 1 plus 0, it becomes 1. 500 plus 0, it becomes 500. So this is a additive identity. 0 is an additive identity. If 0 is added to anything, there will be no change in this thing. And if we add a negative of any matrix, so it becomes 0. A add with the negative A, it become 0. So this is the example of the subtraction of matrix, same as addition. 6 minus 1, 5. 4 minus 2, 2. 2 minus 0 is 2. 3 minus 1 is 2, 2 minus 0 is 2, 7 minus 8 is minus 1. So this is the simple subtraction of matrices. Next move on scalar multiplication of matrices. Scalar multiplication means ke if you multiply any kind of number with the matrix. Matrices can be multiplied by scalar, constant or single element. Constant means any kind of number, any kind of integer, plus 1, minus 1, plus 2, minus 2. If you multiply 2 with the any matrix, it will multiply each entry of the matrix. Let's k be the scalar. So if k multiplied with a is equals to a multiplied with a. If you multiply, if we say that k is equals to 4, 4 multiplied with the whole matrix, and you can see that 4 multiplied with the whole matrix is equals to the whole matrix multiplied with 4, and the answer is same. If 4 multiplied with this matrix, which is 3 minus 1, 2, 1, 2 minus 3, and 4, 1. So 4 is multiplied with each element. 4 into 3, 12. 4 minus 1, 4. 4 2 is 8. 4 1 is 4. 4 2 is 8. 4 3 minus 3 is minus 12. 4 4 is 16. And 4 1 is 4. And same as if a matrix multiplied with 4. This is same as which we discussed in the previous one. The 4 into 3, 12. 4 minus 1, 4. 4 2 is 8. 4 1 is 4. 4 2 is 8. And all that. And the properties of this scalar matrices is, if a single constant multiply with the addition of both matrix, then we can multiply with the single one. If 4 is multiplied with the sum of the matrix, it is equals to, if you multiply 4 separately with A and 4 separately with B and then add on. And this is same for K plus G, any two numbers, any two constant. First we have to add two constants, then we multiply with the matrix, this result is same. If we multiply separately the constants with the matrix and then add on. And if we k is multiplied with the product of the matrix, then we can say that there is no difference between them. And same as the second and the fourth property is relative to each other. So you can understand that the addition, how we add the matrix, how we subtract the matrix, how we multiply the scalar number, a single number with the matrix, there will be no change with the matrix. And what is the equal matrix? Equal matrix is if you say that a matrix is 2, 3, 4, 5, then the second matrix should be 2, 3, 4, 5. Then the both matrix is called equal matrix. Next, move on to the classwork. You have to write the date and day of the corresponding classwork and write the question properly on the notebook and solve these simple matrix by adding each element and mark the answers correctly and give the response of this classwork. And I will also attach the homework worksheets to you to solve these kind of matrices. Next we study inshallah in the next lecture the multiplication of matrices and the inverse of matrices. And after these two topics, we will end this topic and move on to the next topic. So stay safe, stay home. Thanks a lot. Allah Hafiz.